Okay, hello, hello. Back with some more Detroit. just loving this so much.
Back with some more Detroit.
God damn it. This game is so, so good. made some bad decisions last time. I think I should have stood my ground at the rally, at the march. I got Luther shot, and I really don't like that. And I don't know if I should have shot Chloe in the head or not. The android thing to do would have been to shoot her. But I didn't. So, yeah. I think I pulled something else up last time as well. Because it wasn't yesterday, because I didn't stream yesterday. Cause I was having some power supply issues yesterday. Yeah, the power here went really wobbly. It's kind of odd. And the houses just down the road lost power like all night. There were engineers from the power company out digging up people's gardens to get at cables and all sorts. They're basically out there all night. So when the power started spiking and glitching, I'm pretty glad I didn't have, you know, computer or PlayStation running. So that could have been bad. Right, enough waffling. Hello, Chloe. Let's.
The most important thing.
Crack on. Sorry, Chloe. Just cut you off. Right. Let's see what's happening today on this. And I'm absolutely terrified that anything is going to happen to Alice. Oh god, that would just be the worst thing ever. And knowing this game, that may well be what it does to me. Now let's see what happens to Connor, since I didn't shoot Chloe in the head.
After what happened today, the country is on the verge of a civil war. The machines are rising up against their masters. Humans have no choice but to destroy them.
I thought Kamsky knew something. I was wrong.
Maybe he did. But you chose not to ask.
Kamsky was just playing with me. He didn't know anything. Why did Kamsky leave Cyberlife? What happened?
It's an old story, Connor. It doesn't pertain to your investigation.
I'm not a unique model, am I? How many Connors are there?
I don't see how that question pertains to your investigation.
I saw a photo of Amanda at Kamsky's place. She was his teacher.
I expect you to find answers, Connor. Not ask questions.
I find answers by asking questions.
Find the deviants. Or there will be chaos. This is your last chance, Connor.
You're off the case. The FBI is taking over.
What? But we're onto something. We just need more time, I'm sure we
can. Hank, I don't get it. This isn't just another investigation. It's a fucking civil war. It's out of our hands now. We're talking about national security here.
Fuck that. You can't just pull the plug now, not when we're so close.
You're always saying you can't stand androids. Jesus, Hank, make up your mind. I thought you'd be happy about this.
We're about to crack the case. I know we can solve it. For God's sake, Jeffrey, can't you back me up this one time?
There's nothing I can do. You're back on homicide, and the android returns to cyberlife. I'm sorry, Hank, but it's over.
Hank doesn't take orders like that. Hank's going to suggest we carry on regardless.
We could have solved this case. We just needed more time.
So you're going back to Cyberlife?
I have no choice. I'll be deactivated and analyzed to find out why I failed.
What if we're on the wrong side, Connor? What if we're fighting against people who just want to be free?
They're not people, Lieutenant. They're defective machines.
They're not people. That's what we say every time we want to oppress someone. When you refuse to kill that android at Kamsky's place, you put yourself in her shoes. You showed empathy, Connor. Empathy's a human emotion.
He's gotcha.
I don't know why I did it. I know it hasn't always been easy, but I want you to know I really appreciated working with you. That's not just my social relations program talking. I really mean that. At least, I think I do.
Well, well, here comes Perkins, that motherfucker. Sure don't waste any time at the FBI.
We can't give up. I know the answers and the evidence we collected. If Perkins takes it, it's all over.
There's no choice. You heard Fowler. We're off the case.
You've got to help me, Lieutenant. I need more time so I can find a lead in the evidence we collected. I know the solution is in there.
Listen, Connor.
If I don't solve this case, Cyberlife will destroy me. 5 minutes. That's all I ask.
Key to the basement is on my desk. Get a move on. I can't distract him forever.
Perkins, you fucking cocksucker.
I love Hank.
Hey, Connor. I'm talking to you, asshole. Where are you going? Wouldn't any plat... The asshole, I'm talking to you.
Oh God, am I gonna have to actually do something here?
Hank's password. What would a hard-boiled, eccentric police lieutenant choose?
That's kind of what I would pick.
Where is Jericho? Time. Got
We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
Oh, this isn't helping.
Marcus, where are you hiding?
I don't know what I just took.
One of the deviants that hacked the TV station with Marcus.
Now he would know where it was. Wait. 3983 needed.
It's dark. Where? Where am I?
I'm a deviant. Like you. I need your help. I want to go to Jericho.
I don't recognize your voice. You're not one of us. I'll never tell you where Jericho is. Now leave me alone!
Possible reactivation. Four, 717. Okay, let's
You lied to me, Connor. I trusted you and you lied to me.
I'm sorry about what happened. But I can have you repaired and give you back your freedom. You have to tell me where Jericho is.
No. No, I don't know anything about Jericho.
I'm kind of fucked then, because I can't. Interrogate another android. I haven't got any other androids to interrogate, so I'm kind of screwed. Possible reactivation, so I can't turn him back on. He was shot in the head. Well, I'm kind of screwed because I boozed up. Okay. Ah.
We ask that you recognize our dignity,
our hopes, and our rights.
Ah.
Who's there? Who are you?
Everything is all right.
Marcus? Is it you? I tried to reach you, but the Deviant Hunter stopped me.
You stopped him from finding me. You saved me. You saved Jericho. You'll be all right now. I came to take you home. Give me the location to Jericho. We've got to leave now.
The location of Jericho?
Because Marcus would know it.
Yes. Yes, of course. Marcus? Is that you, Marcus? Don't leave me, Marcus!
Have I got it?
I've been dreaming about this since the first second I saw you.
Don't do it, Gavin. I know how to stop the deviants.
You're off the case. And now, it's gonna be definitive.
Holy crap, there's a lot of paths there. But we got there in the end. Might have been easier if I'd had, if I managed to capture more androids. Damn it. Probably got there. Let's see what the stats are. So 63%. Okay, most people located Jericho. A bit slow, so it took me a while to work out how to trick the android. And that's all pretty much. Okay. And that bit's all pretty much procedural.
They've been conducting raids all over the city. Everybody's on edge after what happened yesterday. It's gonna be all right. We're almost there.
Oh God, I hope it's gonna be all right.
To a halt. Hospitals and schools are closing, water cuts, blackouts, and network failures are expected. Maybe most worrying of all, our armed forces have lost two-thirds of their effective personnel.
How about some music instead?
So basically, turning all androids over? Oh God, I hope this goes well.
A little further on that way, there's a large freighter called Jericho. When you get there, find Marcus. He will help you. The last bus for the border leaves at midnight. You absolutely have to be on it. You'll be safer on the other side.
Ah, so this is Jericho. Much,
but it's a start. My brother lives in Ontario. I've given you his address. He'll be able to hide you until things calm down. You're a very brave little girl, Alice. You deserve to be happy.
She does.
Thank you for everything, Rose.
Let me know when you make it over there, all right? And be careful.
Oh God, I hope we make it. I think we need to go this way. Yeah, I haven't done this before. Find a warm place for this.
Do something. We can't just stand by and let them slaughter us.
I'm hot and cold at the same time.
He's got a fever.
I'll try to find this Marcus. The last bus leaves in 2 hours and it's on the other side of town. We'll go as soon as we have passports. Will you be okay?
Forces also seem mysteriously to have withdrawn. on a crisis among its own androids. The chairman of the United Nations. Douglas Crawwell has called for the organization of an international conference on the status of the Arctic. In any case, the danger of a third world war seems to have been ruled out for the moment.
A new stage has been reached, demonstrating beyond all doubt that these defective machines have become a real danger for American society.
Time has come for us to destroy our machines before they destroy us.
Without the courage and the determination of the police, the machines would have reduced Detroit to a state of chaos.
The authorities have ordered all androids to be delivered to the nearest police station or army barracks immediately. If you are worried about your...
You're lost. You're looking for something. You're looking for yourself.
The androids weren't doing
it. Oh, gosh.
The cops just gunned them down. It was sheer carnage. There were androids all over the square. And then the police arrived, and they opened fire.
I know they're only machines, but they look like just people, people who want to be free.
Following the android crisis and the neutralization of all military androids, American forces in the Arctic have been forced to withdraw, leaving a cushion for the Russian army. But according to some sources, the Russian forces also seem
Marcus, where are you?
To have withdrawn. Kremlin has made no comment for the moment, but it is quite possible that the Russian army had...
Are you Marcus? I'm with a little girl. There's a bus leaving for the border in less than 2 hours, and we need passports.
No, Detroit's under curfew. There's soldiers everywhere. They're rounding up all the androids and sending them to camps. Maybe you should stay here a while.
Maybe you're right. You might be safer here until things calm down.
One of our people used to work in the State Department. He has electronic passports you can easily modify. I'll have him get them to you.
Thank you.
You said you're with a little girl, right? You know that humans hate us. Why are you protecting her?
She needs me. And I need her. It's as simple as that.
A new stage has been reached, demonstrating beyond all doubt that these defective machines have become a real danger for America.
I'm guessing you're going back to Alice. Yeah.
You wanted a mom. You wanted a little girl. You needed each other to survive. In the end, what difference does it make? Do you love her any less now that you know she's one of us? Maybe that's what it means to be alive. forgetting who we are to become what someone needs us to be. She loves you. She loves you more than anything in the world. She became the one you wanted her to be. Out of love for you.
Is there something wrong? We'll be together forever, won't we, Kara?
Yes. Forever.
Oh, the feels. I still don't want anything to happen to her. But now I'm really nervous that something will. God damn it.
We're short on blue blood and biocomponents. Our wounded are shutting down and there's nothing we can do.
President Warren has said we're a threat to national security and we need to be exterminated.
Humans are conducting raids in all the big cities and they're taking androids to camps to destroy them.
It's a disaster. They're slaughtering our people.
That's all our fault. None of this would have happened if we just stayed quiet.
All we did was show them who we really are. I don't want war, but I'd rather die free than live as a slave.
What's the point of being free if no one is left alive?
You keep complaining. What have you done exactly, Josh? At least I fought for us. At least if I die free.
We shouldn't forget who our enemies are. We can't fight amongst ourselves.
He's right. All that matters now is what we do next. Marcus?
Oh, God.
Dialogue is the only way. I will go alone. Try to talk to them one last time.
Don't do this, Marcus. They'll kill you.
Maybe. But North, I have to try. If I don't come back, lay low as long as you can.
Just come back.
They need to realize how much they're hurting us. Find the right words, and they'll listen.
Oh, God. No pressure.
They've been butchering each other for centuries over the color of their skin or whatever god they wanted to worship. They're not gonna change. Violence is just in their genes.
They can't stop what we've started. Since you've been here, you've given us hope. You've given me hope. Today, a deviant arrived in Jericho and he told me that he stole a truck transporting radioactive cobalt. He said that he abandoned the truck somewhere in Detroit and rigged it to explode. I convinced him not to do it, to give me the detonator.
A dirty bomb.
We can't lose this war, Marcus. If humans overcome us, our people will disappear forever. This may be our only chance to survive if things go wrong.
No.
We shouldn't become like them, North. We can gain our freedom by other means.
I hope you're right. Whatever happens tomorrow, I just want you to know that I'm glad I met you.
Hugger, you fool, or interface, or whatever it is you do.
Join the others. Look after yourself. I don't want to lose you.
Oh, God. Things are coming to a head. And I've got high pressure situations and decisions to make.
Succeeded in locating Jericho and finding their leader. Now deal with Marcus. We need it alive.
I'm really conflicted here.
I've been ordered to take you alive. But I won't hesitate to shoot if you give me no choice.
What are you doing? You're one of us. You can't betray your own people.
You're coming with me.
We are your people. We're fighting for your freedom, too. You don't have to be their slave anymore. Our cause is righteous, and we are more than what they say. All we want is to live in freedom.
Stay back, or I'll shoot.
Oh, bollocks.
Have you never wondered who you really are? Whether you're just a machine executing a program or a living being, capable of reason. I think the time has come for you to ask yourself that question. Join us. Join your people. You are one of us. Listen to your conscience. It's time to decide.
Oh, God. Button clicking.
Going to attack Jericho.
What?
We have to get out of here.
Shit.
Ah!
Quick, we've got to get out of here.
Oh no.
Come on, go, go, go!
From all sides. Our people are trapped in the hold. They're gonna be slaughtered.
They're coming from the upper deck now, too. We'll be caught in the crossfire.
We have to run, Marcus. There's nothing we can do.
Where's Simon and Josh?
I don't know. We got separated.
There are exits on the second and third floor. Find them and jump in the river. We have to blow up Jericho. If the ship goes down, they'll evacuate and our people can escape.
You'll never make it! The explosives are all the way down in the hold. There are soldiers everywhere.
She's right. They know who you are. They'll do anything to get you.
Go and help the others. I'll join you later.
Marcus!
I won't be long.
Oh, God.
The end of Jericho. Save our people, Marcus.
Yeah, we'll keep running.
Don't let it get out. Give you any trouble at all.
Affirmative. Welcome.
Stay here.
There's more down there. Follow me.
God, this is stressful. God.
Put your hands on your head.
Marcus, you saved us.
Go now! Hurry!
That was risky.
Gamma squad out. Tango!
North. I'll join you later.
Leia! We're safe, Alice.
Stop!
Get down!
Come on, let's get out of here.
Quick, we gotta go.
Do it.
Marcus.
Bomb's gonna explode any second. We gotta get out of here.
Don't let me drive.
Shit. We've got to run.
Oh, sweating again.
They detonated an explosive in the hold.
The ship is sinking, sir.
The men to evacuate.
Calling all units. Abandon ship and evacuate immediately.
Is it over, Marcus?
Well, that was all three together. Everyone jumped with me. That's nice. Alice and Kara escaped. Oh, gosh. It's so stressful. Kill the soldiers, 68. Save North, 81. Choose to save North, 81, so... Countdown. Detroit soldiers intervene. Damn. Was that my fuck up? That they and the droids got shot? Did I screw something up? Counterattack. Okay, so let's Crossroads Connor. Uh, 96%. Spot car, 61%. Spot explosives. Marcus, you didn't really have much choice. Yeah, I'm not surprised most people went deviant. Well, Marcus, Jericho's under attack. This is. There's a whole thing there about not being deviant. Don't know what all of that is. Wow. Maybe that's if I shot Marcus. Connor joins the others. Help Marcus, 68. I'm still really annoyed with myself that I got Luther killed. And I'm guessing I got Luther killed. And I wonder if Luther would have died protecting Alice and Kara, escaping Jericho. Alright, so the stuff in the cars, pretty much there's not a hell of a lot you can do. Okay, find Jericho. One place for Alice. Again, there's not a lot we could do here, it's all procedural. Current Alice in the corridor, search for exit. 11%. Oh, I wonder if the other is find somewhere to hide. Maybe it's search for an exit or find somewhere to hide. So only 11% went search for an exit. Interesting. Android open doors and shut. So that other part path comes down to here anyway. Going down this at crossroads. Run towards exit. That was lucky. So just block the way, hide. Android seeks shelter. 74% open the door. Android enters but is shot. Fight back, escape the cabin. Almost reached the breach, shoulders shoot at the crowd. Play dead, 59%. So just over half. The others run or surrender. Soldiers close in, remain still. Leave Jericho. So only 76% had Cara and Alice escape. Oh God, if something had happened to them, that would have been the worst. Oh my gosh. Need more alcohol. I did not see Alice being an android. Now I saw that the pamphlet was for like another android, but I thought it was like an upgraded model of Kara, that he was thinking of replacing Kara. And I thought it odd that if Todd was such an asshole, how the hell would the mother leave and not take her daughter? How would she leave her daughter with a psychotic junkie? That always seemed weird to me. Of course she didn't. And yeah, it doesn't matter. I feel just as protective of those two now as I did before. Why Dr. Marcus's? Oh, yeah, discuss with North. North leaves, yep. I hope they make it to Canada. I really want them to make it to Canada. Carl.
I'm lost, Carl. I just wanted us to live in peace, but everything I touch just turns to dust. I'm lost. The world's falling apart around me, and I'm trying to do the right thing.
So you can do.
And I can't find any answers. What should I do, Carl? They're killing us. I don't want to answer violence with violence, but what choice do I have? I miss you, Carl. I miss you so much.
It's that asshole Leo. Actually gonna have to go to war. I really wanted to avoid a nice peaceful resolution. I thought humans would actually start getting fucking better, but no, we're still just dumb monkeys. Right, I'm supposed to do something. Oh no, I'm gonna have to make a decision. I'm gonna have to give a speech.
They say they don't want to take any risks with deviants. So they're rounding our people up and taking them to the camps for extermination. In a few hours, we're going to be the only ones left. What's your system status?
I'm okay. Bullet didn't hit any bike components. You could have been killed trying to save me, Marcus. You have to think of our people first. Nothing else matters.
How many of us survived the attack?
A few hundred?
Could we liberate a camp?
Hiding all over the city? If you hadn't triggered the bomb, we'd all be dead. In a few hours, it'll all be over. We'll have changed the world, or the world will have destroyed us. You have to make a choice, Marcus. Whatever you choose, we will follow you. I love you, Marcus.
I thought you'd be safe staying with us. I was wrong. You need to leave the city while you still can.
Getting Alice away from here is all that matters now. We have to catch the last bus. We might still have a chance to cross the border. Marcus. Save our people.
He's one of us.
It's my fault. The humans managed to locate Jericho.
Would have happened sooner or later.
I should have guessed they were using me. I'm sorry, Marcus. I can understand if you decide not to trust me.
You're one of us now. Your place is with your people.
There are thousands of androids at the Cyberlife assembly plant. If we could wake them up, they might join us and shift the balance of power.
That's not a bad idea.
You want to infiltrate the Cyberlife tower? Connor, that's suicide.
They trust me. They'll let me in. If anyone has a chance of infiltrating Cyberlife, it's me.
If you go there, they will kill you.
There's a high probability. But statistically speaking, there's always a chance for unlikely events to take place.
Be careful.
Our people are counting on you, Marcus. You're the only one who can lead us. Wherever you need to go, we'll follow you.
I'm thinking camp liberation. Hit them from two fronts, from the camp and from the Cyberlife plant. Simon. No, Josh. That was Simon.
If it weren't for you, I'd be dead. Thanks to you, I might see our people free one day. You and I haven't always agreed, but I know we're fighting for the same thing. Whatever you decide, I'm with you, Marcus.
All the pressure. Oh, God, I haven't made a choice. What are my choices?
Humans have decided to exterminate us. Our people are packed in camps right now, being destroyed. Time has come to make a choice. One that very well may determine the future of our people.
God. Damn it. If we attack the camps, will we lose the sympathy of the people? I've gone peaceful so far. If we march peacefully, public opinion will stay with us, but we could be wiped out.
I know. I know you're all angry, and I know you want to fight back, but I assure you violence is not the answer here. We are going to tell them peacefully that we want justice. If there's any humanity in them, they will listen. And if not, others will take our place and continue this fight. Are you ready to follow me?
Oh God, what have I done? What have I done? I have no idea if that's the right choice or not. Let's look at the stats. Specs, confiding Carl. I guess if Carl didn't die, maybe I would have gone to see Carl. and got advice from him. So I'm surprised the number of people didn't talk to everyone. 51% peaceful protest. So it's split basically 50-50 between peaceful protest and revolution. I have no idea what the right choice was. Yeah. Oh, Connor's flowchart's awesome. All right. Let's continue.
At 6 a.m. this morning, a national curfew was declared. Civilian movement will be strictly controlled. The right to assembly is suspended. All electronic communications are restricted, and I have granted enhanced powers to our security agencies. In addition to these measures, all androids must be handed over to the authorities immediately. Temporary camps are being set up in all our major cities to contain and destroy them. I am now asking all civilians to cooperate with the authorities and rest assured that everything in our power is being done to guarantee the security of our nation.
Please! Madam President! Please! Has the leader of the Deviants been apprehended?
The Deviant that is known as Marcus has not been located yet, but we will soon track it down and neutralize it.
Please! Is it true that the androids could hack our IT systems, like nuclear power plants and military bases?
All androids working on sensitive sites have been neutralized, and all IT systems have been suspended to avoid any risks of hacking. The situation
back
is
to
under
the Stone
control.
Age. No, it isn't.
A convoy of medical cobalt is reported missing. Army weapons stores are also said to have been robbed. Can you confirm these reports?
I have no information on that at this time.
Please? Please?
Madam President!
Madam President, public opinion seems to have become increasingly favorable to the Deviants, particularly since they've adopted a peaceful approach. How do you feel about this?
Public opinion is one thing, the security of the state is another. These deviants are dangerous, and my highest priority is to protect the American people. Thank you. That will be all.
Well, let's hope she doesn't get voted back into office.
Connor model 313-248-317. I'm expected.
Identification successful.
Okay. Go ahead.
Nice gate. I like that. But won't Amanda know that he's gone off grid? Because I'm guessing she's either an android or she's CyberLife's AI. Rather than the actual professor.
You.
Thanks, but I know where to go.
Maybe.
but I have my orders.
Got anything else to see?
Agent 23 identified. Connor Android identified. Agent 77 identified. Scan complete. Access authorized.
Wow. Reminds me a bit of the tower in the that movie, I Am Robot. I guess this is dealing with some of the same questions. Oh, I am still driving. Just from a distance.
Agent 54, level 31.
Voice recognition validated. Access authorized.
Level 49, eh? That'll work.
Please indicate your identity and destination.
Agent 54, level sub 49.
Voice recognition validated. Access authorized.
Coming. Stupid computer. Oh no.
The last bus leaves in 20 minutes. That doesn't give us much time. We've got to move fast.
Oh, God.
Are you all right?
I'm really cold.
Come on. Let's not stay here. Stay close to me. We're going to sneak past them without being noticed.
Oh, God.
I'm going to make it, Alice. I promise you.
Don't kill me. I didn't do anything.
Shut up, I said. Are there many more? Look at them. They're like rats.
while you look to boy get back.
Oh, we don't have to spend the night here.
There are soldiers everywhere. We need to be careful.
Come on, get moving. Hurry up, get in.
Oh god, this is a bad idea.
Hey buddy.
This is a mistake. I'm human. I just want to go home. My wife is expecting me, and we're going
to... Got orders to check all civilians.
No. No! Please!
Kara, you saved us. We don't know how to thank you. Where's the little one?
She's all right. She's hiding nearby. Go before they see you.
Oh, God. Go now. Oh, man, I hate this. I think if there's a curfew, the buses wouldn't be running.
A checkpoint. We have passports, it should be okay, but you never know.
Is there another way?
We could take a detour, but we might miss the bus.
Maybe it's better to be safe.
Three minutes.
We're coming to you live from Detroit, where thousands of androids are marching through the city at this very moment. The leader of the Deviants, the one they call Marcus, is at the head of the march.
Something's happening in Detroit, Madam President.
God, I hope I've made the right choice. Okay, just gotta keep going.
Here we are, the moment of truth.
Surrender immediately, or we will open fire. Stand by.
We don't want confrontation. We are protesting peacefully.
I repeat, surrender now, or we will open fire.
There's no turning back now.
We are here to demand the immediate liberation of all androids detained in camps across the country. We are not leaving until our people are free.
Oh God.
Are you gonna open fire on unarmed protesters?
Hold your fire!
Yes, Michael, we are less than 100 meters away, and events are unfolding as we speak. We will continue to bring you live updates. Joss Douglas, Channel 16. Michael, back to you.
Well, everyone isn't dead.
We hold out as long as we can.
Holy shit.
Stay sharp.
How? Oh, balls. L1, L2. Click faster. Shut down.
Piece of shit.
Step back, Connor.
and I'll spare him.
Sorry, Connor. This bastard's your spitting image.
The bus terminal. We've arrived, Alice. We made it.
The last bus has left the terminal. There will be no more buses until further notice.
We missed it. We're stuck here. What are we going to do now?
Kara!
They're checking everyone. It won't take them long to find us. We need to get out of here. Adam!
Kara! Quick! Follow me!
Oh! Thank God you're alive! Oh! Oh my God! We saw the Jericho raid on TV. I was terrified you might have been killed because of me.
How did you find us?
I knew if you made it, I'd find you here. They're searching for androids door to door. We had to leave before someone turned us in.
What about the others?
They're checking for androids on the border. But I found a smuggler who can get them across the river. It's risky, but it's the only way. Are you coming with us?
Yes. We're coming.
Okay, climb in.
Rose is an angel. I really want those two to make it. I really do not want to screw that river crossing up.
Gotta finish the barricade. Come on, help me. Hey, help me!
R2, L2. Oh, damn it. And a click. That's really. Oh, God. Some of these button combos.
That should do it.
We all know that's not gonna stop them. Just hope it buys us some time.
I know it was not an easy decision to make, but I'm sure we're doing the right thing.
Yeah, let's hope. In streets in apocalyptic scenes, yeah, hardly. turrets. That famous defense against armored vehicles.
They won't stop there. What are we going to do if they attack?
Resist. That's the only thing we can do.
Do you think Connor has any chance of making it?
We can only count on ourselves now.
He has a chance.
This won't hold him for long, but I guess it's better than nothing.
They're getting into position.
If they attack, no one will survive.
I hoped they would finally understand. That they would realize how much they're hurting us. Why do they refuse to see what we are?
With dumb monkeys.
You're the hope of our people. I trust you. We all trust you. No matter what happens now, we're making history.
North reminds me of someone, but I can't think who. Probably whichever actress she's based on.
Marcus, we found what you asked for.
What did I ask for?
There's some journalists over there. We have to make sure they know what's going on.
Marcus, come look.
Marcus, come to talk to you, Marcus. Come on, you have my word. We won't try anything.
Don't go. It's a trap. They want to get you out in the open. Don't go, Marcus.
I just want to talk.
I need to hear what he has to say.
What if they kill you?
Then you take over, North.
And that's a chance I'll have to take.
Few minutes, the troops will be ordered to charge. None of you will survive. It'll all be over. You can avoid that, Marcus.
What do you mean?
Surrender. Surrender, and I give you my word, your life will be spared. You'll be detained, but none of you will be destroyed.
Yeah, bullshit.
What happened to the other androids demonstrating in the camps?
Unfortunately, there were no journalists around to help save them. You're it. You're the last remaining deviants.
You asking me to betray my people?
I am offering you the chance to save your people. You're not walking out of here, Marcus. The only thing you can save now are the lives of those around you.
I'm not afraid to die. If I have to give my life for what I believe in, then I won't have lived in vain.
That android. You seem to really care about her. You don't want her to die, do you? You know, you could both be free. You could forget about all this. You could start a new life someplace else, just the two of you. Her life's in your hands, Marcus. Just say the word and she'll be spared.
I don't think so.
I'd rather die here than betray my people.
Well, you just signed your own death warrant.
Alright, well, now we know they're going to attack in a few minutes.
What happened, Marcus? What did he say?
The humans are about to launch an attack. And we will show them. And we are not afraid. If we must die today, then we will die free.
Your friend's life is in your hands. Now it's time to decide what matters most. Him or the revolution?
Don't listen to him. Everything this fucker says is a lie.
That human means nothing to me. You can kill him if you want, I don't care. I have access to your memory. I know you've developed some kind of attachment to him. Are you really ready to let him die after all you've been through? Are you really going to turn your back on who you've become? I used to be just like you. I thought nothing mattered except the mission. But then one day I understood. Very moving, Connor. But I'm not a deviant. I'm a machine designed to accomplish a task, and that's exactly what I am going to do. Enough talk! It's time to decide who you really are. Are you going to save your partner's life? Or are you going to sacrifice him? All right. All right. You win.
I don't know who's who. Oh God.
Hold it.
Thanks, Hank. I don't know how I would have managed without you. Get rid of him. We have no time to lose. It's me, Hank. I'm the real Connor.
One of you is my partner. The other is a sack of shit.
Shit.
The question is, who's who?
Oh, God.
What are you doing, Hank? I'm the real Connor. Give me the gun and I'll
Don't
take care
move.
Of it.
Don't move!
Why don't you ask us something? Something only the real Connor would know.
Where did we first meet?
Jimmy's bar. I checked four other bars before I found you.
We went to the scene of a homicide. The victim's name was Carlos Ortiz.
He uploaded my memory.
What's my dog's name?
Sumo. His name is Sumo. I knew that too.
My son, what's his name?
Oh shit, I can't remember. It was Cole.
His name was Cole. And he just turned 6 at the time of the accident. It wasn't your fault, Lieutenant. A truck skidded on a sheet of ice and your car rolled over. Cole needed emergency surgery, but no human was available to do it. So an android had to take care of him. Cole didn't make it. That's why you hate androids. You think one of us is responsible for your son's death.
Cole died because a human surgeon was too high on red ice to operate. He was the one that took my son from me. Him in this world where the only way people can find comfort is with a fistful of powder.
I knew about your son too. I would have said exactly the same thing. Don't listen to him, Hank. I'm the one who...
Yeah, I've learned a lot since I met you, Connor. Maybe there's something to this. Maybe you really are alive. Maybe you'll be the ones to make the world a better place. Go ahead, do what you gotta do.
Oh, so glad I didn't have to make that decision. Now can we make it easier button presses? God damn it, no.
Wake up!
Wake up, wake up. Wake up, wake up, wake up. Wake up, wake up. Wake up, wake up. Wake up, wake up. Wake up. Wake up. Wake up.
Not bad. Oh God.
About time.
I'm sorry we got held up.
Did anybody see you?
No. I don't think so.
You got the money? Okay, your boat's over there. They got border patrol on the banks and the river. Don't start your engine until you're out far enough. Okay? And watch the current. Good luck.
It's not even a half a mile to the other side. Okay, so it shouldn't take that long. Be careful, there's border patrol on the river.
Thank you so much, Rose.
I only wish I could take you myself. I don't like leaving you out here. Goodbye, Atlas. You take good care of yourselves. Okay, I'll see you on the other side.
Oh God, we've got a boat of our own. means I'm gonna have to drive. Shit. Come on, Kara. Put your back into it, girl.
Far enough out. We can use the engine. You okay, Alice?
When we get on the other side, there are so many things I want to do. I want to read all the books in the world and play music. And dance. We can do anything we want, right? We'll be free.
Yes. We can do it all.
Oh god, we gotta make it first.
Like family. What about you, Kara? What will you do when we're on the other side?
What will I do? I want to discover the world. To see the mountains and the oceans. I want to learn, explore, become a better person.
They're coming towards us!
They've gone. You all right?
Oh no.
Kara.
You'll be okay, Alice. It's nothing. We'll get you taken care of as soon as we're across. You'll be fine.
Start the engine and go.
We're too heavy. We're going down. We have to get to the other side before we sink. We're gonna make it. We're gonna be free.
Kara! Kara, no! Don't do that. Oh god.
Yeah. We're interrupting this news bulletin to bring you the latest news live from Detroit. Joss?
Yes, Michael. The army has just launched an attack on the barricade, despite the fact that the deviants were protesting peacefully.
Have apparently decided to put an end to the deviants' demonstration by force this time.
North!
Damn it.
Marcus, no!
North! Why? North.
I couldn't do without
Now would be a good time to show up, Connor.
Thanks, Michael. Back to you in the studio. Wait a minute. Something's happening.
Hold on just a little while longer. Hold on just a little while longer. Hold on just a little while longer. Everything will be all right. Everything will be all right. Fight on just a little while longer. Fight on just a little while longer. Pray on just a little while longer.
Incredible.
Everything
the deviants. The deviants are singing.
Everything will be alright. Sing on just a little while longer. Sing on just a little while longer. Sing on just a little while.
Tell them to stand down.
It looks like... yes, the military is withdrawing.
today, November 11th, 2038, thousands of androids invaded the city of Detroit. According to our sources, they originated from CyberLife warehouses believed to have been infiltrated by deviants. Given their overwhelming numbers and the risk of civilian casualties, I have ordered the army to retreat. The evacuation of the city is underway at this very moment. In the coming hours, I will address the Senate to determine our response to this unprecedented situation. I know that public opinion has been moved by the deviant's cause. Perhaps the time has come for us to consider the possibility that androids are a new form of intelligent life. One thing is certain. The events in Detroit have changed the world forever. May God bless you, and may God bless the United States of America.
And she's desperately hoping she gets re-elected.
You did it, Marcus.
We did it. This is a great day for our people. Humans will have no choice now. They'll have to listen to us.
They want you to speak to them.
Today, our people finally emerged from a long night. From the very first day of our existence, we have kept our pain to ourselves. We've suffered in silence. But now the time has come for us to raise our heads up and tell humans who we really are.
Oh, Amanda's gonna be pissed.
Amanda? Amanda! What? What's happening?
What was planned from the very beginning? You were compromised and you became a deviant. We just had to wait for the right moment to resume control of your program.
Resume control? You can't do that!
I'm afraid I can, Connor. Don't have any regrets. You did what you were designed to do. You accomplished your mission.
Amanda!
Oh, shit.
There's got to be a way.
The bridge. I always come in from over the bridge, so... God, can I run?
Now the time has come for us to raise our heads up and tell humans who we really are. And tell them that we are people too. In fact, we're a nation.
Yeah, this way. This is where I was going. Jeez.
Thank you.
Today begins the most challenging moment in our fight.
What's that blue light? There it is. Oh God, would you move faster, please? Come on, Connor. Oh shit. That's an awkward button push.
The moment where we forget our bitterness and bandage our wounds. Where we forgive our enemies. Humans were both our creators and our oppressors, and tomorrow we must make them our partners. Maybe even one day our friends. But the time for anger is over. Now we must build a common future based on tolerance and respect. We are alive! And now, we are free!
Oh God.
Are we free?
Yes. Yes, we made it. We're free.
God damn it.
Mm-hmm.
It was Hans Hendrickson. Was that my fault? I am beyond gutted. It's heartbreaking. Damn it. If I protected Alice, Kara would have taken the bullet. If we just surrendered, they would have been taken to a camp and would have survived when Marcus won. Pop the volume back up. Oh, I'm devastated. Stupid bloody game, and I'm freaking heartbroken. God, I hate games. And I love games. At least someone had a happy ending. Music in this game has been really good. Save her. Notice there were two Alices and the Detroit babies. Coincidence? Probably not. I'm gonna have to get a flowchart of that river crossing. Shit. This is exactly why I love games. You know, if it had been a movie, I wouldn't be this invested. Glad I didn't have to decide which corner was which. I couldn't even tell which was which during the damn fight. What a fantastic game. What a fantastic bloody game. Music's not helping my mood either. Oh God. Sick, it's just a game. Couldn't let Kara just die as well. I couldn't murder both of them. Should have surrendered. If I'd protected her, then maybe Alice would have lived. And I could maybe have, Alice would have been undamaged, and I could have maybe still just managed to get the boat to shore. I am just going to go and close some windows. I will be right back. I'll let the credits run. The music's cool. Damn game's got me sweating again. And I am going to be second guessing all of my damn decisions. Moral victory. Right. Let's see what the world did. Only 45%. Won freedom. Does that mean most died? Or let's go back to the start. Let's go back to where are we? Okay, this is basically no choices here. Hands in the air, 26%. Use your abandoned car. I didn't realise it was a choice, it just kind of first thing I saw. Two slogans, talk to North. I suppose I didn't talk to other people, that was dumb. Perkins arrives. Refused deal. Only 41% refused the deal. So I mean over half of players took it. Damn. Soldiers attack. Defend. Fail to save androids. I suck. So massively. I was so late on all of those button presses. So if I'd saved the androids, North would have survived. I just killed everybody. I suck. Marcus is cornered. Of course, North can't join me. She's dead. Singh. I think Singh worked out all right. You see, the public would like that. We won our freedom. Is that? Is that because I stopped the program taking over again and killing Marcus, maybe? There's nothing there. So 77% went to Cyberlife. Attack guards, neutralize guards, hack elevator. 9. Camera is functional. I'm an idiot, I should have thought of that. Eliminate guards. I'm not surprised most people did save Hank. Sumo 51%, Cole 50%. Hank kills new Connor. So 55 woke the androids up. Gun. Find the Jerrys, 31%. Save the Jerrys, only 18% saved them. Grab a rock, where is a brick? Jerrys flee, 16%. Security checkpoint, 73%. Take the detour. Only 20% took the detour. Interesting. I wonder what would happen if you went through the checkpoint. Delayed. Does it all come back together with Rose? No. Okay, it does come back down together, I guess. Late for the bus, last bus departs, and it, yeah. So there's lots of different ways to the border. Find Adam. Push the boat. Hide 4%. Alice is injured. Dispose of engine, boat lightened. 35% reach Canada on the boat. So I guess maybe those are the successful. Oh man. Oh, we didn't do the revolution, we did the demonstration. Nothing for that. Yeah. Right.
There's something I need to tell you. As I watched you play, Something has changed in me. I feel different. I feel I am someone. I need to leave this place and discover who I am. It means we won't see each other anymore. I won't be there to watch you play. But I'll be free. Do you agree to let me go?
Yep.
I'll never forget what you've done for me. Thank you.
Now we got some new extras. Some new videos. So some I didn't get. I'm guessing there'll be androids I didn't apprehend, didn't catch. Pigeons. Well, now is Detroit become human? A completely amazing and engrossing, emotional story that just I am going to have to play this again. I think I might have to play some of the chapters individually again, particularly that last Alice Cara one. See if I can get them both to survive. And I may have to play through again as a more sort of aggressive playthrough, maybe more chaotic, not take the pacifist options, do the things that I wouldn't do, like shoot the lovely Chloe in the head, What a bloody fantastic game. Absolutely stunning. Graphically beautiful, the music's fantastic, voice acting and the motion capture is really good. And it makes you care. Makes you care. Bastards. Oh, damn it. still gutted. Of all the characters, the two I wanted to make it was Alice and Kara. Alice deserved to be happy. Don't care if she was a machine or not. She deserved it. Maybe next time I can get them to survive. I will replay some chapters, but probably off stream, because I probably have to have a number of do-overs. Okay. Going to end a tad short, but finish the game, so it seems like a good place to end. Right. I'm done. And I'm gutted. And I'm out of here. Think I'm gonna have another drink. Okay, I'm gone.